go. They forget how short I am. Welcome, good evening, and welcome to the winter concert. And as you saw, we have a fabulous sixth grade band who will be starting the concert for us tonight. We have a mix of all kinds of things to play for you this evening. We have some standard band tunes, along with a few holiday favorites tonight. And we are so glad, in spite of, I'm thinking like some type of flu bug or something is going through the school, so I'm very glad that they made it. Everybody looks so great. We can't wait to play for you tonight. Before we begin, I know I always have to be so careful. Would you please make sure your electronics are turned down? We certainly worked so hard on our music this evening, and it would be nice if that wasn't interrupted. So if you would be kind enough to check that. Tonight for our concert, don't tell them. This is the hardest music I've ever done in a sixth grade concert. And I've done each of these pieces. Yes, give them a round of applause. That's fantastic. I've done each of these pieces before with sixth grade, but I've never done all of them in one concert. So they have really worked hard. We're going to start this evening with a combination of seven different Christmas songs. This is called Christmas Mashup.
Thank you.
months of playing. It's wonderful. We would like to continue this evening with another holiday favorite. I tell this story every year, but it just amazes me. I was thinking from the last song. There was a teacher at school a couple of years ago who came running to the band room one morning, and she was listening to the radio in the morning, and she said that there was a DJ who said, "I was at my kid's first concert last night, so maybe I'm being just a little picky, but he said, I want you to listen to the recording, and I will give a prize to the first person who calls in and tells me what the name of the song is." And he said, "I will even tell you, it's a standard holiday favorite." And for 30 minutes, people called and called, and finally, after 30 minutes, he had to tell them it was Jingle Bells. So, not only did we do Jingle Bells, but they did a lot of other tunes very, very well. So for our next song, we'd like to do another holiday favorite. This is Santa Claus is Coming to Town. Different instruments, so I gave the students the opportunity to audition, and I'd love to give everybody a solo, but we'd be celebrating Christmas, I think, right here in the auditorium. So we did select a few to represent us tonight, and we're going to start off with Trent playing Down by the Station. Japanese folk song called Sakura Sakura. Very nice. Very nice. Next up, we have Megan with the Camp Town Races. So the first one to play is going to be Austin. Nightmare. Here it is, but Malcolm plays it so well, you gotta love it anyway. Here's Malcolm with Baby Shark.
Thank you.
Very nice. Thank you. All righty. Next up, we had a few people who did really well on Up on a Housetop. So we kind of paired them together. And first we're going to have Lamia and Cameron playing Up on a Housetop. Beethoven's Ode to Joy that we're going to have two people play. The first tonight is going to be Hannah. Very nice. Nicholas, we have Lily and Amaya. Thank you. the guts to get up on our first concert and play in front of all these people. So they did a great job tonight. Before we play our last number, I just wanted to give a couple quick thank yous. First of all, I hope that you'll help me with a round of applause for our wonderful auditorium crew who make us look so professional up on the stage. To anyone who donated a raffle prize, who sold tickets. This is one of the best raffles we've ever had, and we ended up selling 950 out of the 1,000 tickets. So thank you, thank you, thank you for your help. Alrighty, this next tune, you would think it's pretty simple because it only uses the first six notes we learned on our instruments, but it is anything but. If you didn't have a fantastic percussion section back there, you couldn't do this piece because the rhythms are really, really tough. Thank you so much for coming this evening, and we would like to leave you with Resolution. Winter concert. Would you please give a big hand and welcome to the stage the 7th grade band. planned for you this evening. Before we do, I want you to help me give a big hand. I wish we had capes that we could put on the back of some of the uniforms, because there is someone tonight who would get one. Our snare drummer this evening, unfortunately, got the flu, as many of our students have right now. And Joey from the 8th grade band came in this morning and learned all of the music in one day. All right, so we begin this evening with a prehistoric suite.
Thank you.
How'd you like that battle scene there at the end? Scary. Scares me every time I listen to it. And there goes the gong, so. All right, for our next tune, we want to lighten it up a little bit. It is the holiday season after all. And we would like to play just an old standard favorite for you, Frosty the Snowman. Week, another superhero movie, and this is an Aquaman, but we are going to take you to the water because we have a battle that we want to play for you. I forget that Disney did a cartoon on Hercules, so when I went to explain to the kids about Hercules and his seven quests he had to do, they're like, yeah, we know all about it. Okay, so our last song we'd like to play for you is one of the tasks that he had to perform. This is Hercules versus the Hydra.
Thank you.
We'd like someone to come in and do a jazz program with middle schoolers at 7 o'clock in the morning. And of course, everybody jumped at it. And we would get pretty much a new person for every year. And I can't get rid of this guy. I can't believe we were just talking backstage, and I said, "How?" And he said, "This is his fifth year with us." I can't believe it. If he ever tried to leave, I would have them lock the doors. I'd like to introduce to you, along with the middle school Central Jazz Band, the incomparable Josh Zapor.
Hello. So we're going to start with a real simple jazz ensemble tune. We play it every year to kind of get the kids ready for the different kind of playing that you do in a jazz band. It's gonna feature improvised blues solos by Caitlin on piano and Matthew on bari sax. So listen for that. They are solos that they came up with themselves. It's pretty cool. This is Jammin' with Charlie. This year we're doing Let It Snow, Let It Snow, Let It Snow, and I'm actually super glad it hasn't so far. Hopefully this doesn't bring it on. Most of the kids know I commute. So this is our first tune of the year that features a swing feel, which is a brand new kind of playing for our seventh graders, so the eighth graders are more used to it. It just takes a little time to get into this style of music. So I hope you enjoy. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. It actually takes a long time to kind of learn how to play with that swing feel. So that's a really good start in it, and I'm excited to see what these guys are able to do in the spring this year. Before we go on and play our last tune of the evening, I do want to thank everyone for getting involved in the jazz band. I know it's a commitment getting the kids to the school early every morning. I know sometimes they're kind of moody when they get there, so I can't imagine what they're like at home. So I do appreciate it, everyone, all the parents are making the extra effort to make this happen, and all the kids. Our attendance this year has been really good, and I'm excited to see where this group can, what they can accomplish going forward. And lastly, I'd like to thank Mrs. York for bringing me back every year to do this. I really do enjoy it. So our last tune is going to be Uncle Milo's Sideshow, and it's another kind of straight-ahead rock tune that we've been working on for a few months. So.
Thank you.
I told them we saved the best for last. All of our groups are doing great tonight, though, aren't they? Everybody's playing wonderfully. All right, for this evening's finale, we have the 8th grade band. And this evening, we would like to open with a song that is a lot of fun. You're going to be able to tell how much we love to play it. The composer took a trip to Greece and was so inspired by the music. I think he got to go to a wedding while he was there. And you can just picture the Greek dancers going around the wedding when you hear this music. This is called One Night in Athens. We're talking about, you know, you become a band director because you absolutely love to play your instrument. And then you become a band director and you never get time to play. And so I made it a goal that I was going to start playing again. And I'm in two performing groups now, different bands. I got to perform at Orchestra Hall last week, so that was a real treat. And that group that is run by the Detroit Symphony Orchestra had a guest in. And when I heard him sing, I said, holy cow, you have to come sing for us. And this is an old spiritual that many sang in elementary school. Some of you may remember learning Wade in the Water. And I said, we absolutely cannot play this without you coming and singing it for us. So I would like you to welcome to the stage a fabulous performer who's going to inspire us tonight for our portion. He was going to sing for you first. Would you please welcome to the stage Mr. Richard Ross?
Thank you.
has become a standard that we do every year. It's a tradition with the 8th grade band. And we like to refer to it as your mean one, Mrs. York. Here is the Grinch. Before we go this evening, there are always a lot of thank yous I have to give. First, I'd like to thank, we have a student who was kind enough to come and record the concert tonight so that we can watch it in our classroom. So thank you, Doug, for coming and doing that tonight. gigantic thank you to our fantastic auditorium crew for making us look and sound so professional up here on the stage. If we could give them a really big round of applause. I put some special thank yous in the program. Thank you to all the parents who rode the bus today. Thank you to Mrs. Perkins, who's been doing the emails for us and gotten that system going, so that's fantastic. Thank you to Mrs. Klebert for making us look so professional in our uniform. She came in and did those for us. And I know there are a lot of other people to thank. Did you guys have a great time at that picnic this fall? Wasn't that awesome? Thank you to all the people who participated in that and helped out. That was fantastic. I'd also like to say a really big thank you to everyone who helped with this year's raffle. Between the gifts that were donated and the tickets that were sold, we sold about 950 out of the 1,000 tickets. So we did awesome this year. Thank you, thank you. And the person I have to say the biggest thank you to couldn't make it tonight because she's one of the people that had her daughter has the flu, but Mrs. Silich, when you see her, give her a big hug because we're all benefiting from her hard work. Also, I'd like to say thank you to the parents. I know tonight was kind of, today was a hectic day. The flu's running around, there were basketball tryouts, there was, I think there's a basketball game, there was a field trip today. There's just everything going on before the holidays, so thank you. And lastly, I'd like to say thank you to the wonderful Lance Creuse administration. I know our principal is here tonight, Mrs. Glynn, and we have such supportive administration and everyone in the district. So if we could give them a big round of applause. Thank you so much for our program. We'd like to end this evening with an old standard. And at the conclusion of this evening's performance, I'm going to grab a couple pieces of paper. I'm going to put them up here. And seventh graders can sign out at the end of the evening. And I thank you so much for coming. We'd like to end this evening with Majestia.